All right, so kicking things off, we're going to be showcasing two variations of this deck. One variation is going to include Chompy, an SP unit, and the other variation will include just more free-to-play base units. So let's, he's got Pink Fury. We could go with the Chompy in the back. I think that's a safe bet. We'll keep the Barbarian King as a reserve here, but essentially with this deck, I mean, Chompy is going to be the carry. Chompy can get some pretty solid value with the super buff from the Barbarian King, so that is going to be the main play here, is getting that value with the Barbarian King, getting the super value, so keeping the Barbarian King alive as long as possible with that second upgrade. That's going to be the key here. So second upgrade is definitely the upgrade to go in this specific matchup, so let's grab that right now. And then I also want to reroll for Chompy. I want to make sure we're getting as much Chompy level ups as possible. We do have Chompy right there, so I'm not going to reroll. We do have two Elixir. We could reroll and get that Archer, but it's not really going to provide much value for us at this point because he's probably only going to be playing upgrades here. He actually only threw down the Lumberjack, so he's going to be sitting on 15 Elixir with that Pink Fury. We do have the Revive on the Chompy. So when the Pink Fury gets her super off, it's not going to actually get the Elixir because Chompy has not technically died because of the revive. So really good play for us there, and we're going to be able to secure a round two victory. Sending into round three, he is sitting on 29 Elixir after this round ends. Yep. So let's grab Chompy upgrade here. We'll go for Chompy level 3, but I do want to grab our Archer. Yep. And now we'll go Chompy level 3. If we can get Witch here, that would be nice. Yes, we do get the Witch. Okay, we're going to go with... let's go with the Skeletons. I'm actually going to put my Archer here. The reason I'm going to put my Archer here is because I want to make sure Chompy takes longer to get to that front row. So that way the Pink Fury will focus onto my Barb King and give the opportunity for my Chompy to just roll up. Oh, he's going to be going with a Fisherman. Shark bait combo. So he pulls everything in. Everything's gonna be focused onto my Barb King. He is gonna get the Pink Fury super down. Chompy's starting to get the stacks rolling through, and we should be able to get a nice clean victory here. Chompy with the 3-star just mowing this comp down. A quick 3-0. GG, well played. We're gonna showcase another matchup with that deck because, I mean, a 3-0. I mean, it's nice. It's nice to see that we get some 3-0s with this deck. It is a very strong deck, but I do want to showcase it a little bit more. And this one's against a Shield Maiden. Now, a lot of people think Shield Maiden is really strong. I mean, Shield Maiden is really strong. But in this particular matchup, when you have Chompy with the self-heal, the healing tile is just the icing on the cake in this matchup. But obviously, at the time you're watching this video, you might not have healing tile active. Maybe you do. But this healing tile is super helpful when it comes to playing Chompy versus Shield Maiden in this deck specifically, but it's not required because Chompy's second upgrade is 100% HP steal. So with the effect of the tile, you do get that extra HP, but the HP steal is really what drives us home for Chompy versus Shield Maiden, getting the buff from the Barbarian King as well, and also being able to revive. So Chompy's got some extra lives, extra legs to him, no pun intended. But let's grab the Barb King upgrade here, and I'm gonna keep Chompy. I wanna make sure we're getting Chompy upgrades. Chompy is the key in this matchup. That's what we're gonna grab. He gets positioning with the Battle Boxer. He's not gonna be able to, he is gonna be able to connect with our Witch with that Battle Boxer upgrade. So we need to make sure that we're taking the Battle Boxer and kind of having it super aimed down instead of being able to connect with that Witch. So great Battle Boxer placement from him there. That was a very heads up play. So let's grab, we're going to go with the, the Hog Rider placement would be really nice there. Let's grab Chompy with the res. Let's go with the, grab Chompy with the heal. I want to hit his Archer. I think we kind of have to play the Hog Rider here for the Battle Boxer. Let's go with the Hog Rider here. We'll keep that Battle Boxer back. This will give our Chompy an opportunity to get to the front line and be able to get some pretty decent value. So Hog Rider is going to jump through. Everything's going to focus on that. Now we have Hog Rider on that backside distracting the Battle Boxer. We have our Archer hitting his Archer, which is going to be really good for us. Chompy is going to be able to tank that Battle Boxer shot while getting some really good value onto the Mini Pekka. We do get some damage onto his Archer. Chompy is just cooking away. He has only 5 stacks. We need to get that stack infinitely rolling through for Chompy. He's going to be able to clean up the Pekka on that backside, and we do have enough HP to take that Archer down. So he's got the 4 specialists, he's got 2 clans with the Villager and Archer, and then he's going with the Saint buff with the Shield Maiden and the Battle Boxer. So what we can do now is I want to grab our... I feel like I should just go Chompy level 3. Yeah, I think we just need Chompy level 3, and then let's reroll, and let's have the Witch spawn in a few more skeletons. This will be super valuable for us. If we go to around 5, that's when we'll grab the Magic Archer to have the attack speed increased for our Archer, so that way we can take his Archer down. But right now, most important is to get that value on to Chompy and make sure he's able to get that those stacks built up from the skeletons going down and everything else. So Chompy's got 4 stacks right now. He's got 5 stacks, 6. Skeleton's gonna get taken down. He's up to 9-10. Look at the stacks roll for Chompy. He's sitting at 11 stacks right now, 12 with the takedown from that Villager, and that is gonna be GG, well played. Have you ever seen a 14 stack Chompy? Well, now you have. All right, here we go with the Barb King. We're going up against Wave Master here. This is gonna be interesting. Let's see, we want to go with the Musketeer forward. Let's go with the Archer in the back. So this way the Wave Master will actually go to the Archer, leaving our Musketeer free. That should be some pretty decent value for us. He's going to go with the Swordsman as well, so he's going to get that energy buff. Could be 4 Cs with the Wave Master. It could also be 4 Undead with the Wave Master. That is quite the interesting deck that I played. Be on the lookout for that video, because it's a kind of like a recap video covering my matches in Clash Mini Worlds. And I played a very interesting Wave Master deck that actually clutched it up for our team, and we were able to win that match. So let's see what we got here. Okay, so we're gonna go with the Dart Goblin. Let's also grab the... I don't want to grab Barb King if I can. Let's grab the Magic Archer in case we don't roll Barb King here. We don't roll the Barb King there. That is very unfortunate. All right, let's roll these. We'll keep that Magic Archer in our back pocket. Let's see, what else do you have? He's just gonna go full Swordsman level 3. We don't have our upgrades on to the Barb King yet, so Swordsman's actually gonna get some pretty decent damage here. We're gonna be able to get some value with all of 4 of our archers, and yeah, that is looking real good. Okay, we don't know what else he has though, so he hasn't upgraded the Wave Master. He could throw the Swordsman to our side, which would push the Wave Master over to the right-hand side. So we do have to be careful of that. Let's go with the Barb King upgrade. And I want to go with our Miner on this healing tile here, actually. This way, if he happens to have Prince or anything, we'll get some value here. If he has Fisherman, he'll pull the Musketeer instead of the Magic Archer, which is not ideal, but it's fine. It's not going to be too much of an issue. He's going Hog Rider on this left-hand side. Yeah, he's going to take that left-hand side down as quickly as possible. And now he's going to get the push with the Wave Master onto this left-hand side. And we really just need to upgrade this Magic Archer and get as much value down as possible so we can win this fourth and final round. Because getting that Magic Archer upgraded, that Wave Master is not really going to be able to take it down quickly. It's going to have a lot of HP, and it's going to be a struggle for him to deal with. So let's grab the attacks deal plus 2 damage to injured. Now our Magic Archer is sitting on 39 health with a 0.95 attack speed, which is going to be huge. And if we can get the boast upgrade for that as well, then if we need to go to round 5, that's exactly what we'll do. We'll grab that boast, but we should be in a pretty good spot. He is going with the 4C buff, which is perfectly fine. Now we just need to go. So we'll go for the upgrade onto the Magic Archer, and then we'll also go for the upgrade onto the Miner to get that energy drain so we can try to prevent that shark bait from pulling all of our units in. Actually, I don't even know if we'll need it. Barb King able to get another super off. It does, and there it is. GG, well played.